I actually got the Cybertruck pre-ordered, so I was like, it's no need for me to have two Teslas. So I traded in for the i5. It really caught my eye.
So what make you stick with electric?
Bro, I mean, I save tons of money, especially in the places that I live at. Pretty much everything be free charging. In a sense, I really don't drive like that, but I do. And I don't really go out of town, so I mean, it's convenient for me, you know. And they say it's good for the, you know, the earth. So I'm an earthy type of person. And it's the future, you know what I'm saying? Like, why not? You know, and I don't have to go to gas stations, so that cuts down on a lot of stuff. So yeah, here we are. Right here.
Do I just return this to the...
I'll take it from you. You got anything at the cup?
Let me check real quick.
Okay.
That's good.
Everything?
Appreciate it, bro.
Yeah, absolutely, bro. We got water, snacks, if you want to help yourself out the bar.
Okay.
I'll get your paperwork and we're going to get your car pulled up and get you going, okay?
I appreciate it.
Absolutely, bro.
Yeah, I want some chips here, yeah, but so.
What kind of chips you like, bro?
Let me get the Cheetos.
I got you. You want
the hot one? They take care of you here, man. Yeah, look at that. Appreciate it, brother.
City and shit. I come with BMW, put some waters in the car, like I'm an Uber driver.
Right now, I need you right now. I'ma be there when you call for me. I'ma be there when you call for me. I need you right now. I need you right now. I'ma be there.
Sipping dope at the little meditation out the kush. Trigger high tech and Trish.
I can charge it at my house and everything too, so.
That's what's up. Very cool.
Appreciate it, bro. Yeah, man. So yeah, bro, let's go to the Hawks and Heat game tonight, bro. It's your boy Y6, and I'm doing the introduction of my i5. It's a brand new trim level for BMW this year, 2024. It's been in the shop for the last couple days. I just got it like less than like a week ago, but I guess they having like a big recall on like the flap where you charge at. So the flap had to get replaced, but I just got my baby back today. You know what I'm saying? The things that I'm happy about my car, before I get into that, the car I traded in was a Tesla. So a lot of people like, damn, bro, you traded your car in for a Tesla? You traded your car in for a BMW? I thought you was Tesla forever. Don't get me wrong, I am Tesla forever, dog. I actually got the Cybertruck pre-order, so I was like, it's no need for me to have two Teslas. So I traded in for the i5. It really caught my eye. A few things that caught my eye, you know, they always keep the BMW symbol right here in the middle, but also you got your blue calibers. You got your LED lights in the front. Also, you got the LED lights going around the grill. So at nighttime, it looks like a doggone monster coming down the road. With your camera in front too. And also the eye for electric, you know. Also, it got your parking sensors in the front all the way and around. You got your panoramic roof. I had to get the panoramic roof because on the Tesla, I had the panoramic roof. I was like, yeah. And also, one of the things that I was also concerned about too before I got this car was, let me see. A deal breaker was, I was like, man, I got a Tesla. If I go anywhere, I could charge anywhere. So for you people that thinking about possibly getting rid of your Tesla or getting something else, they have Electrify America and they're everywhere. So I was looking, so one of the things I looked at was trying to see if I can go from here to Cali in it and I won't have an issue. Another thing I got on my jank, I got bird's eye view, so I get an all around view of the vehicle. So this is the thing I was telling you guys I had to get fixed. It wasn't opening so I could charge, so I had to take it in, but now it's open with my charge ports. Also, another good thing they have on the 5 Series, and I also was a previous 5 Series owner, but they have the 5 right here. That's pretty cool. I like that. I really like that. Another cool feature, but I had it on mine as well, but it's still on here. All I gotta do is kick and it open.
Hold on, do that again.
So I'm like, you know.
Are you kicking it closed too?
Yeah.
Okay.
So you can't beat that. Tesla don't have that. I got plenty of space in the back. I got plenty of space in the back. Hold on. Pretty cool key too. I like the keys on here. And also you have the option too, because I'm so used to not having a key with my Tesla. You can use your cell phone, can still be a key too. I just haven't set that up yet. So yeah, still got that option. So yeah, you got plenty of room back here too. My seat is just a little back. But, you know, and that's just for right now. I really, just to be like on the standard size, I could have it up more. I just was chilling in the car for a second. Also, I'm a reader. So this is what I'm currently reading right now. The Way of the Superior Man. Get it at a Barnes & Noble's near you. Oh, also, with this in the back seat. How you doing? Also with this right here, you can put tablets right here, tablet holder, and they also have a charging port right there as well. And another thing that I really, really like, that I'm glad I'm back with BMW, like you can change the ambiance, the lighting inside of it. And also I just seen that the lighting is right here as well. So I got that flamingo color going on right now in the car.
Oh, so you talking about all them lights up there, you can change the color of it?
Yeah, so it'll change all the colors in the car, so yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Now let's see. The charging ports back here, too. So. All right, let me show y'all the front. You know what I'm saying? The driver. Where I'm going to be at. know, they got this crystal shit going on, you know what I'm saying? Touch. Another thing that really made me want to get another car, and I love my Tesla, but my dog Calvin had a Mercedes, and you know, in the new luxury cars, like the screens go all the way around. I was just like, damn, that shit hard. Like, don't get me wrong, the Tesla hard, but shit, really all that shit had is just a screen in it. You know, even though I could do everything on it, but like, nigga, like, I got so much other things that I can do in here. So like, yeah. And I got heads-up display. You know, heads-up display been around for a while, but this one has it as well, so I can see.
I don't think you can see it from right here. Is it up there?
Nah, you can't really see it right now because I ain't driving.
Okay.
So, yeah. So, like I said, and I got the M-Sport wheels, the M-Sport steering wheel. Got the M-Sport package. Yeah. I love the leather. The leather in here is very nice. It's better quality than my Tesla. I'm not really trying to compare my Tesla and this. I feel like they're in like two different classes. When it comes to vehicles, you know, everybody knows BMW is more your luxury. My Tesla, you can still say that it's luxury, but it's more so just, I don't know, it's more like a convenient car. It's like, I really don't even know how to word it, but it's just, it's very convenient. And this is in a way, but it just has a little bit more, like people at your dealership say, got a little bit more bells and whistles on it. So I think that's what really made me get something different before I got my Cybertruck. Before that comes, I can't wait till that comes. That's gonna be a new addition to my fleet. But this, I'm loving it. I really haven't got a chance to break it in. Like I said, I had to take it back to the dealership to get the flap open, get the flap fixed. So let's start her up. So like I was saying, my homeboy Calvin got a Mercedes, and that shit was just so cool. I was just like, I had to get the whole screen. Like, this is just so, like, luxurious. Pretty much everything is here, touch screen. Down here, you can see how much battery life I have. I can also change this display up here as well to other things. Let's see. I haven't really got a chance to play with this car. I can change it to, like, a compass. Oh, yeah. This is a pretty cool feature right here. So as I'm driving, my front camera sees the front of the car.
Oh, that's crazy.
Yeah. So on my dash, so you got that feature. What else? I got assisted view. I got range prediction. What else? Then I pretty much got my digital dash speedometer on there as well. I got my time. What percentage my battery life is on right now, how many miles I got on my battery. Also gives you the speed of what it is currently on this road. On over here, I still get a pretty much a lot of things. Like I said, I haven't really got a chance to break in my car yet, but you get Apple CarPlay. Also you can play games on here. There's a lot of stuff on here that I can pretty much do that I feel like I'm not missing from my Tesla. I can still watch YouTube on here. I'm pretty sure videos. Let's see what this does. Videos is probably another software that I can listen to music. I mean, watch shows or something like that. I got Sirius Radio, Spotify, same things that I had in my other vehicle.
You gotta show them how you can cut it up and cut the volume up and down without touching anything.
Oh, so Blue likes this feature right here. So let's play something real quick. So you can turn it down, you can turn it up, and you can turn it down by just twirling your finger. You know the pretty
low flow, shit, super tight shit. Real life, my dreadlocks on my moon type shit. Cook a nigga up like a full type shit. Push off of my thighs, cook a moon type shit. She creeping all of my bars, I got a moon type shit. Thought they cover my flaws, I ain't had to brand new type shit. Come around, jam with the best.
So yeah, I got that feature too, you know. Like I said, the lights in here is pretty much everywhere. I also got a charging pad. What I did have in my previous car too, that I can see that's in this one, that I could charge right here. Somebody could charge right here and I could charge right there. So yeah, I have that as well. I got plenty of space in here, in my compartment, in my glove box too. I think the only thing that I really miss about my other vehicle, that it's not really a deal breaker because I think I feel like I got it in my trunk, another under compartment, is I don't have a trunk in the, a frunk in the front, but I didn't really use the frunk like that. I mean, I had stuff stored in there, but the stuff that I had stored in my frunk in my Tesla, I got it stored in the back, but under the trunk compartment. So I feel like I still got pretty much the same space. So yeah, from there, I mean, this concludes my.
Oh, don't forget to show on the roof.
Oh yeah,
gotta show the roof.
Yeah. So yeah, panoramic roof, just like the Tesla. Maybe the Tesla's a little bit more aggressive with the panoramic roof because pretty much everything is glass. You know what I'm saying? You still got all this little work part right there. So, but other than that, I'm happy with my i5, my 2024 i5. If you need a car, go to Nally BMW on Church Street in Decatur, Georgia. It's your boy Y6 Rari. We out.